Should the National Indigenous Times disappear from the media landscape, it will leave an enormous hole in the coverage of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander affairs. 2 weeks ago, the 14-year-old newspaper was placed into administration and then put up for sale on the weekend. While the paper's future looks bleak, former National Correspondent Gerry Georgatos says it might yet survive to stir another day.
Well, just like NITV, its imprimatur is national. So what we've got in terms of Indigenous-specific media is actually limited to the National Indigenous Radio Service, the National Indigenous Television, to the Koori Mail, and to the National Indigenous Times. If we lose the National Indigenous Times, we lose substantively one of the four major voices that are national in this country for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. I've been with the newspaper as a contributor and writer. I'm not an employee, and I've worked for them effectively pro bono with only expenses paid, and I've done it out of a passion. And, you know, I understand that my name, alongside Gimilaroi language speaker Marcus Waters and Jeff Bagnall, Canberra-based, have become synonymous with the paper in the last 3 years. But the paper resonates with people, and what we've done is a lot of advocacy journalism, through care journalism, outcomes-based journalism, and carried stories that have actually made a difference. We lose that voice, we also lose part of that advocacy.
So what has happened to cause it to fold?
Well, it's difficult for me to actually respond to that question substantively because of legal matters, and I've had to take legal advice before coming in to stick to the facts and what's permissible. There are matters before the court. There is a defamation matter before the court. There are legal matters that have drawn the NIT into substantive legal costs. Apparently, outside these legal costs, the paper's viable. One of the matters is actually a defamation matter. It involved stories that covered the Yindjibarndi peoples of the Pilbara. It involved Fortescue and the allegation that a divide had been contrived between the Yindjibarndi people to suit the native title mining interests of Fortescue. Whether that's true or not, I can't speak to that any more than what I have, but that's the defamation matter at hand, and the legal costs have become a burden for the newspaper.
So, Gerry, obviously a lot that we can't talk about today, but we can talk about the future. Can I ask, do you think NIT will survive?
Well, I hope it survives, Nat. If that voice is lost, the National Indigenous Times, which I've often called the National Indigenous Voice, if that voice is lost and it's hard-hitting coverage and the voices that we brought to the fore and heralded is lost, it'll be near a travesty. It'll be a huge disappointment for a lot of people. I've been travelling the country widely in my predominant work, which is actually suicide research, suicide prevention research, and wherever I go, and especially in these last 2 weeks since it's become news that the National Indigenous Times will be out of business soon, it's actually affected a lot of people. So I don't want to see that loss. In terms of its future, what I'd like to see happen is that, well, what I'm praying will actually happen is that it'll be owned 100% by First Peoples, that out of the blue from somewhere will come a bid to buy the masthead and to keep it going, because the paper shouldn't be lost.